1 in 3,600. Those are the odds that the single largest volcano by volume in the entire Cascade Mountain Range will erupt each year per the U.S. Geological Survey. The volcano in question is not a stratovolcano such as Mount Rainier or Mount Shasta, but rather a super-large shield volcano known as Medicine Lake. While this vast shield volcano, which measures a whopping 50 miles long and 28 miles wide, has produced a number of geologically recent eruptions that look near identical to those of Hawaii's Mauna Loa volcano, Medicine Lake has also in the same time frame produced a series of highly explosive eruptions. As, just during the Holocene Epoch, aka since the year 9700 BCE, Medicine Lake has through separate eruptions emplaced lava flows which had a composition of basalt, basaltic andesite, dacite, and rhyolite. Some of these eruptions have devastated quite large areas with a grand total of 36.4 square miles or 94.25 square kilometers being overlaid by a layer of lava, which averaged 37.8 meters or 124 feet thick during this time span. Medicine Lake's recent eruptions have largely occurred in clusters where across a 100 to 300-year long period, frequent eruptions occur, only to be followed by absolutely no eruptions for the following period of several hundred to several thousand years. Three such recent eruptive periods emplaced lava flows from 5200 to 5100 years ago, 3200 to 3000 years ago, and 1250 to 950 years ago. This suggests that when the Medicine Lake volcano reactivates and produces its next eruption, that it will be followed by a period of heightened eruptive activity for at least the following century. While the Medicine Lake volcano during eruptions can produce volcanic hazards that include pyroclastic flows, lahars, and ashfall, its main threat are potentially long-traveling lava flows which could make their way towards several nearby communities. For example, a voluminous basalt eruption which began at a vent just south of Medicine Lake's summit area in the year 10480 BCE would send lava flows a whopping 30 miles to the south before the eruption ended, nearly reaching what is now the modern community of Donna. Because of these hazards, the U.S. Geological Survey classified Medicine Lake as a high-threat volcano. Medicine Lake's unusually high eruptive rate during its lifespan can be owed to it being situated in a region where there is both magma generated due to the Juan de Fuca plate subduction underneath the North American plate and existing in a zone of west-to-east extension. This extension is situated just outside the northernmost extent of the Walker Lane region, which accommodates the majority of motion the San Andreas Fault does not accommodate, originating from the North American and Pacific plates sliding past one another. What I am trying to say is that not only is subduction occurring, but extension is providing a path of least resistance for magma to intrude into. The first eruption 500,000 years ago created an absurdly large rhyolite lava flow which measured 7.5 miles east to west, 1.2 miles north to south, and was up to 200 meters thick. While some basaltic eruptions occurred during this period, they were not common until around 300,000 years ago when the volcano entered its peak phase of activity. Frequent effusive to moderately explosive eruptions across the next 120,000 years built layer after layer of basalt and basaltic andesite lavas, creating much of the volcano's modern shield profile. Due to Medicine Lake's tall height, it at several points had thick glaciers which covered sections of its edifice. A portion of these glaciers subsequently melted during a major ultra-Plinian eruption 180,000 years ago, which sent pyroclastic flows a whopping 15 miles to the southwest. This eruption completely devastated the area, but most importantly caused the first part of its caldera to form. Many rain faults were created, which subsequently erupted three voluminous andesite lava flows during portions of the next 80,000 years, deepening its existing caldera until it created its modern appearance. Subsequent lava flows during the most recent 100,000 years have covered nearly half of Medicine Lake's edifice, with dacite and rhyolite eruptions occurring quite rarely in clusters, specifically 30,000, 3,000, and approximately 1,000 years ago. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Happy the Man Fan, for supporting this channel.